Hello. It's Thursday, November 17th, and I'm Emily Douglas with UFX Markets Daily News. The U.S. dollar advanced against the major currencies despite a statement from Fitch yesterday that it might downgrade the credit rate for some American banks, which are exposed to the European markets, if the European leaders don't find a solution for the debt crisis quickly. Wall Street closed negative as the Nasdaq fell by 1.7% and the Dow Jones by 1.6%. Crude oil rose by 3.2%, closing at $102.59 a barrel, which marks the first time since May that crude oil has passed $102 a barrel. Gold fell by 0.4%, finishing at $1,774.30 an ounce. Today, building permits are expected to be 0.60 million versus 0.59 million previously, and unemployment claims are expected to come out at 396,000 versus 390,000 previously. The euro fell to a one-month low against the US dollar, signaling that Europe's debt crisis is spreading. The CPI came out to 3.0% as expected, and the core CPI came out to negative 0.1%, worse than the expected 0%. As long as the euro-US dollar is trading below the 135.50 level, momentum remains negative for the euro and will probably continue to decrease. The next support level on the one-hour chart is located at 134, and breaking this level will probably lead the pair towards 133.10. Overall, the euro-US dollar traded with a low of 134.27 and with a high of 135.56. Today, the CPI is expected to remain unchanged at 3.0%, and the core CPI is expected to remain at 1.6%. The British pound decreased versus the US dollar on negative data, such as the unemployment rate, which jumped to 8.3% versus 8.2% previously. As long as the Great Britain pound US dollar is trading below the 158.47 level, the pound remains bearish. The next support level is at 156.70, and if the pair breaks this level, we'll probably see it declining towards 156. Overall, the Great Britain pound US dollar traded with a low of 157.21 and with a high of 158.25. Today, retail sales are expected at negative 0.2% versus 0.6% previously. The yen strengthened against most of the major currencies as the debt crisis in Europe continued to make headlines, causing investors to remain with the yen as a refuge currency. The US dollar-Japanese yen has been trading with a very narrow range, without specific momentum in the last 3 days. And only if the pair breaks the 76.80 level will the yen be attractive again. Overall, the US dollar-Japanese yen traded with a low of 76.84 and with a high of 77.13. No publication of economic news is expected. The Canadian dollar decreased against the US dollar for a third day, though it rose versus most major currencies, amid signs of a US economic recovery and as crude oil rallied to above $102. As long as the pair is trading above the 101.60 level, the US dollar's momentum is positive. The next resistance level on the one-hour chart is located at 102.80, and breaking this level will probably cause the pair to continue to rise towards 103. Overall, the US dollar-Canadian dollar traded with a low of 101.71 and with a high of 102.87. Today, foreign securities purchases are expected to come out at $9.24 billion versus $7.92 billion previously. Thank you for joining us today. For more information, please visit us at www.ufxmarkets.com for all your online trading needs. I'm Emily Douglas, wishing you happy trading.